Hello everyone, and welcome to the fourth video of our series Create a Turn-Based Strategy with Unity. In the previous videos, we have set up our Unity project, connected it with GitHub, and started working with the Unity editor. We have created our first scripts, Hex Grid and Hex Metrics, which laid the groundwork for today's topic, Procedural Mesh Generation. Procedural Mesh Generation is a powerful tool in game development. Instead of manually creating complex 3D models, we can use code to generate them automatically. This can save a lot of time and allows us to create more complex and dynamic environments. This is, of course, one option. Later, we will explore the other option, with building a map from a set of pre-designed tiles. In our turn-based strategy game, we are using a grid of hexagons as our game map. To create this hexagonal grid, we are going to use a script that we have called Hex Grid Mesh Generator. This script is responsible for generating the mesh of our hex grid. Our Hex Grid Mesh Generator script works by using the properties of our hex grid, such as its width, height, and hex size, to calculate the vertices of each hexagon in the grid. It then uses these vertices to create triangles, which are the building blocks of any 3D mesh. The resulting mesh is then applied to the mesh filter and mesh collider components of our game object. The Hex Grid Mesh Generator script also provides functionality for clearing the hex grid mesh. This is useful for when we want to regenerate our hex grid with different properties. The script contains several public methods that allow us to create a hex mesh with different parameters. We can create a hex mesh by specifying the width, height, hex size, orientation, and layer mask. We can also create a hex mesh by specifying a hex grid and a layer mask. In our Hex Grid Mesh Generator script, the first thing you'll notice is the require component attribute at the top. This attribute automatically adds required components as dependencies. In our case, it ensures that our script's game object has a mesh filter, mesh renderer, and mesh collider component. If these components are not present, Unity will add them automatically. This is particularly useful because our script relies on these components to generate and display the mesh. The awake method is a special Unity method that is called when the script instance is being loaded. It's commonly used to set up references between scripts and to initialize variables. It's best to use awake to define any dependencies between scripts, set up references, or initialize variables that need to be ready as soon as the game starts. In our awake method, we're checking whether hex grid is null. If it is, we're trying to find a hex grid component on the parent of our game object. If we still can't find a hex grid, we're logging an error. This is a good practice as it allows us to ensure that our script always has the references it needs to function properly. Now, let's look at the create hex mesh method. This is one of the public methods that we'll be calling from our editor script. It's an overload that uses the properties of our hex grid to create the mesh. When we press the Create Mesh button in our custom editor, this method will be called. The Clear Hex Mesh method is also public and will be connected to our editor script. It's responsible for clearing the mesh from our game object. It does this by accessing the mesh filter and mesh collider components of our game object and clearing the mesh. If there is no mesh to clear, the method simply returns and does nothing. When we press the Clear Mesh button in our custom editor, this method will be called. These methods make it easy for us to create and clear our hex mesh at the press of a button, directly from the Unity editor once we create a custom editor. Let's dive deeper into the Create Hex Mesh method. This is where the magic happens, where we actually generate our hexagonal grid mesh. The method begins by calling Clear Hex Grid Mesh, which ensures that we're starting with a clean slate. Then, it calculates the total number of vertices needed for the entire grid. Each hexagon in the grid has 7 vertices, one at the center and one at each corner. So, the total number of vertices is 7 times the width of the grid times the height of the grid. Next, we create an array to hold all of these vertices. We then loop through each cell in the grid. For each cell, we calculate its center position using the hex metrics. Center method. We store this center position in the array, and then we calculate the positions of the corner vertices by adding the results of the hex metrics. Corners method to the center position. Once we have calculated all of the vertices, we need to create the triangles that make up each hexagon. Each hexagon is made up of 6 triangles, and each triangle is defined by 3 vertices. So, we create an array to hold all of these triangles, with a total length of 3 times 6 times the width of the grid times the height of the grid. We then loop through each cell in the grid again. For each cell, we define the 6 triangles that make up the hexagon. Each triangle is defined by 3 indices into the vertices array, one for the center of the hexagon, one for a corner, and one for the next corner. The corner index is calculated to loop back to the first corner after reaching the last one. Once we have defined all of the vertices and triangles, we create a new mesh and assign the vertices and triangles to it. We then recalculate the normals, bounds, and UV distribution metrics of the mesh to ensure it displays correctly. Finally, we assign the generated mesh to the mesh filter and mesh collider components of our game object, and we set the layer of our game object to the grid layer. The mesh is now ready to be displayed in the Unity editor. Let's have a closer look at the Mesh class to better understand how we're using this information. The Mesh class in Unity is used to create and manipulate triangular surfaces, also known as meshes. The two most important properties of a mesh are its vertices and its triangles, which are represented as arrays. The vertices array is an array of 3D vectors, with each vector representing a point in 3D space. Each vertex is a corner of a triangle. For example, if we have a square, it has 4 corners, and hence 4 vertices. A cube has 8 corners, and hence 8 vertices. In our hexagonal grid, each hexagon has 7 vertices, one for the center and one for each corner. The center vertex is needed to form the triangles that make up the hexagon. The triangles array defines how the vertices are connected to form triangles. Each triangle is defined by 3 integers, which are indices into the vertices array. The order of the indices is important, as it determines the direction in which the triangle faces. In Unity, the front face of a triangle is determined by the order of its vertices using what is also known as clockwise winding. If the vertices are numbered in a clockwise direction, the face is facing you, otherwise it's facing away. In our hexagonal grid, each hexagon is made up of 6 triangles. Each triangle is formed by connecting the center vertex of the hexagon to 2 consecutive corner vertices. When we create a new mesh, we assign our vertices and triangles arrays to it. Unity then uses this information to create the triangular faces of the mesh. We can then manipulate this mesh in various ways, such as by recalculating the normals or the bounds to ensure it displays correctly in our game. Some of you might have figured out that the mesh could be further optimized. We could use only the corner points as vertices and construct an individual hex from 4 triangles, a center rectangle, and 2 triangles on the sides. This would, however, make it more difficult to subdivide and use the topology, as we'd be losing the radial symmetry. Now that we have covered all the technical parts for the script, let's make it easier to use it. Unity's built-in inspector is great for a wide range of tasks, but sometimes you might need more control over how your scripts and data are presented in the editor. This is where custom editors come into play. Custom editors in Unity allow you to override how your scripts and properties are displayed and interacted within the Unity editor. This means you can design a user interface that's tailored to your needs, which can make your workflow more efficient and your project easier to understand and use. For example, you can create sliders for numeric values, add buttons that perform custom actions, or even design complex interactive visualizations. Anything that helps you better understand and manipulate your game's data and behavior can be a good candidate for a custom editor. In our case, we want to add a Create Mesh and Clear Mesh button to our Hex Grid Mesh Generator script in the inspector. This will allow us to generate and clear our hexagonal grid mesh directly from the Unity editor without needing to play the game or manually call methods from a script. It would also be helpful to see the coordinates of the hexagons for easier debugging. This can be a huge time saver, as it allows us to quickly see the effects of changing our grid parameters without needing to write extra test code or navigate through game menus. Plus, it's a great way to make our script more accessible to team members who may be less familiar with coding, as they can manipulate the grid directly from the editor. We've got 2 custom editor scripts to look at, Hex Grid Mesh Generator Editor and Hex Grid Editor. Editor scripts all need to be in a folder called Editor. You can have multiple folders called Editor, and it doesn't matter where they are in the project folder structure. The only thing that matters is the name. Let's start with Hex Grid Mesh Generator Editor. The first thing you'll notice is the custom editor attribute at the top of the script. This tells Unity that this script is a custom editor for our Hex Grid Mesh Generator script. This means that whenever we select a game object with a Hex Grid Mesh Generator component, Unity will use this script to display that component in the inspector. Inside the onInspectorGUI method, we have a call to drawDefaultInspector. This tells Unity to draw all the default fields and properties of our Hex Grid Mesh Generator component. Then, we cast our target to a Hex Grid Mesh Generator. Target is a built-in property in Unity Editor scripts, and it represents the object that we're currently inspecting. Next, we have 2 calls to GUI Layout button, which create our Generate Hex Mesh and Clear Hex Mesh buttons. If a button is clicked, we call the appropriate method on our Hex Grid Mesh Generator. That's it for our Hex Grid Mesh Generator Editor. It's a simple but powerful way of extending the Unity Editor and making it easier to work with our components. Now, let's move on to our Hex Grid Editor. Here we want to display the coordinates of individual hexes around their center point. Like before, we have a custom editor attribute to tell Unity that this script is a custom editor for the Hex Grid component. The onSceneGUI method in this script allows us to customize the scene view in Unity. We're looping through every cell in our grid, calculating its center position, and displaying two labels. One shows the offset coordinates of the cell, and the other shows the cube coordinates. By creating these labels, we're adding a visual representation of our grid coordinates right into the scene view. It's a perfect example of how custom editors can help you better understand your game's data and behavior. And that's it for today's video. We've covered how to create custom editors in Unity, and how to use them to extend the Unity editor. I hope you found it helpful. In the next video, we'll go over how we can convert between different coordinates, like you've seen in the last editor script. We will also learn to convert mouse clicks into a hex. Don't forget to subscribe, like, and share if you found this video useful.